Hello everyone, my name is Dan. I hope you all are doing great because today I'd like to start a new tutorial series based on the principles of object-oriented programming in C# and Unity. In today's video, we're going to be covering what are classes and what are objects. To start off, let's talk about classes. Classes are basically blueprints for the objects that we're going to create. As we go on through this video, we're going to understand that furthermore. So let's start off by creating a class, shall we? We do that by using the class keyword, and then we follow by adding a name to our class, and it can be literally anything, but for this tutorial, let it be person. So inside this person class, we can now add some fields. For example, let's give this person class a name string. A person may also have an age, so let's give an integer called age. And now let's also give some sort of method, because classes can also have methods in them. So how about we add a method which will output a message of that person introducing themselves? So just like this, we have created this class of a person successfully. Now we can use this class to create an object from it, and we can do that in this Unity script that I made called person manager. So let's create a start method. Inside of it, let's create a new person. We can do this by writing the new keyword and then specifying the name of our class. And just like this, we've created an object of the person class. Now we can also store this object into a variable. And there you go, we have successfully created a person object. So now we can specify the values that this person object may have. Let's make it Alice. And let's give this person an age of 18, for example. So this is one of the ways of initializing an object. And so let's also call the introduce method that we made earlier in our person class. And this is basically how you use objects. So now if we go to Unity, I have this little scene right here. I have an object called person manager, which has the person manager script attached to it. If we run the game right now, if we take a look at the console, we should get our appropriate message right here. As I said, this is one of the ways you initialize an object. So the second way is to use an object initializer. So in this way, you have to open curly brackets, and inside of them you have to assign the values of the class separated by a comma. Now let's try and make some more person instances. So now, as you can see, we have created three different kinds of person objects using the same class. So to conclude, if classes are blueprints, then objects are the product that are built using those blueprints. That is basically the simplest way of explaining what a class is and what an object is. So there is actually one more way of initializing classes, and that is by using constructors. First, we have to actually create the constructors, and as their name suggests, they basically build an object of a class. To make a constructor, we need to write public and then the name of our class, followed by round brackets and then curly brackets. So constructors basically act like functions that return a new object of the class where we are implementing it, and we can pass in arguments into this area, into these round brackets. And then we can assign those arguments to the values that we have in here. and we need this keyword in here for our program to not get confused between those arguments and those variables, because they have the same name. And this keyword ensures that we are assigning the arguments to our variables. Now, if we go to our person manager script, we can see that there are some errors showing up, and that is because we've created a new constructor and we are not using that constructor properly, because we are just passing parameters and not arguments. So let's fix that. And so this is a much more cleaner way of initializing the class, if you agree with me, of course. We can also create one more constructor. Well, we can actually have an unlimited amount of constructors, but we can have a constructor that takes in no arguments at all, and we can pass in some default values like this. If we now take one of those person objects and we remove those values from it, then this is also gonna work, because we have another constructor which takes in no arguments. Now, so far we have been assigning all of the data to our objects inside of the script. But what if we wanted to do it somewhere else? For example, in Unity's inspector. Well, we certainly can do that. So let's try and create a person variable right here. And now let's take a look into our Unity project to see whether or not if we have the person variable show up. And as you can see, we have nothing inside of here. And that is just because our person class at the moment is not serializable. To make it serializable, we need to go to the person class and we need to basically add the system.serializable attribute. And we need to make sure that it's right on top of our person class, right here. And if you don't know what attributes are, I strongly recommend that you take a look into the Microsoft's manuals, because there are many kinds of attributes out there. Even Unity has some, such as serialize field and others. So you may be asking, what is serialization? Well, serialization is the process of converting objects into a stream of bytes to be able to save them into memory, a database, or a file. To put it simply, we basically can use serialization to store and save objects. So if we now take a look into Unity, we should be able to see that we have the person variable show up, and then we can basically pass in the parameters that we want to in here. This can also be an array, and everything will work just fine. Last but not least, let's talk about MonoBehaviours. So MonoBehaviour is actually also a class, and whenever we want to make a Unity script or a script that can be attached to some game object, we want to make sure that our class is deriving or inheriting from the MonoBehaviour class. And I will talk about inheritance in a future video, but for now, you just need to know that inheritance works like this, through a colon and then following by a class after it. If we look inside of this MonoBehaviour class, we can actually see that it has all of our methods and fields that we use day to day when working inside of Unity. Unity basically adds in to the component list every single MonoBehaviour that is created by us. That's how we can basically attach it to any game object. And theoretically speaking, if we go to our person class, and if we make it derive from MonoBehaviour, then our person turns into a component which can be added to some game object. There you go. So that's it for this little video today. I hope y'all were able to learn something new, and I'll see you guys next time. See ya!